ideology when it is saying risk reduction. Geographical reach, it can reach to the multiple countries. Here is a list actually. What ISO is really working about the different standards, and you can go through that. And 10, 20, 30, 40 is there different stages. So it is in progress, one can understand. So use cases, they have one standard, terminology, privacy and personally identifiable information, security risk, threat vulnerability. You can go through this. There are a number of standards which are under development, and ISO, different committees are working on that. I'm sure in some other slide it should come, but at the same time, let me tell you that IEEE Standards Association is also working on the different type of the standardization. Because ISO is looking the standardization more from the process perspective, while the IEEE is looking at more from the technology perspective. So both the standards development activity are going on in parallel. So I'm flipping this slide so that we can have some more time for the use case discussion. But there are a huge number of standards which are going on. This is the one particular standard which I picked up just for the understanding, that 2345/2019, which gives you overview and interaction of the smart contract. You will also learn what is smart contract, which is the implementation of the blockchain technology. Ethereum is the platform which is offering the most popular smart contract, or is the founder technology which is offering the smart contracts, and you can develop the DAF, that is distributed application related to this. So let me connect to the smart contract quickly so you can appreciate that part. Smart contract is such a contract that there are two unknown parties in the world in two different geographical locations, and they really want to know that they want to do the transactions, but they don't want any third party in between. So they agree to the certain terms and conditions. All these terms and conditions are getting coded into the blockchain, and a contract is executed. And once the contract starts, then there is no human intervention. Whatever is agreed upon, as soon as data goes into that contract, the subsequent steps are getting executed. I'll give the simple example that I am sending, let's say, the 10,000 unit in one container. So as soon as container reaches there, they should pay me. So when container reaches to that country, and the on the dock, when it gets registered, that container has been landed here in this country, the smart contract will get activated, and it will fetch the money from the buyer's account. And money will transfer to the seller's account. That is, person who sold the material, money will automatically flow. There is no human intervention in between, that somebody will go online and transfer the money, or somebody will write a check and deposit in it, or somebody will do the net banking, or somebody will do the Google Pay. Nothing like that, actually. The smart contract takes charge and fetches the money and transfers. That level of control is available into the smart contract as a implementation aspect of the blockchain. That I'm sure you would be learning in the subsequent 4 days time. So this is the index part, that how the standards are being developed, that what is the scope, what are the references, terms, conditions, symbols. So huge set of things are there, and the concept of the smart contract, how it will get operated, what is the difference between on-chain and off-chain smart contract, how the real world can access the blockchain as a capability. There are two types of the blockchain for your connected. There is one private blockchain and public blockchain. In case of the public blockchain, I can give the access, read-only access to anybody, so that anybody can enter and they can see the transactions which are happening. So that way you can achieve the transparency also. I'm not keeping this slide for a longer period, but there is a huge detail which is going on, and standards have been developed. IEEE blockchain standards, there are certain active projects, and if somebody is interested, can always go to https blockchain.ieee.org/standards, and you will come to know that these are the things which are listed here are really active, and if somebody is really interested, can go into the detail and can learn that. And even there is a scope that somebody can do the research and can achieve the PhD into the just blockchain standards as a domain, and that much potential, that much detailing, that much complexity is there into the whole process of the blockchain standard. So let's connect to the use case and spend last, I believe, some 15 odd minutes into the use case. So cryptocurrency is, of course, the use case. Agriculture, yes. Land records, transportation, subsidy disbursement, my microgrids, vehicle registration, KYC process, insurance, identity management, transaction processing, document provenance, full traceability, voting, medical records, automated escrow. You should read the concept of escrow. I will not be able to take up at the moment, but all of you should read and understand. The music distribution, Visa, MasterCard, Swift. So all the credit card related transactions, everyone has tried and done the different exploration of this technology into this. And I would also like to say, right, let me tell the limitation of the blockchain. Blockchain is relatively very, very slow. And per second, Ethereum used to offer maybe 18 records or 18 transactions, let me correct it, 18 transactions per second. While Visa, MasterCard are expecting few thousand transactions every second. So blockchain has to improve its speed, its capability, so that the credit card related technology or credit card related transaction can leverage the benefit of the blockchain technology. So I will start with a case study of the Vine, which is something which I like the most, the way in which they have done the use of the blockchain. There is a premium brand of the wine in the USA. And when I say premium brand, the cost of the one bottle of the wine is in the range of the $1,000 and plus. So really it is a premium. So they thought that how to gain the trust of their customer, and how to increase the customer, how to increase the loyalty of the customer. They utilize or put the blockchain as a technology into the real world. What they did that right from there are, they identified that in the complete wine process, there are 70 important touch points, right from the selection of the seed till the time somebody picks up the bottle and start consuming the wine. So they identified 70 odd touch point and started capturing the data for each touch point when that particular process is being performed. And this data is captured into the blockchain environment. So obviously nobody can change the data at the later date. So they identified this, wrote the process and identified which are the seeds selected, which is the farm which has been selected, under what temperature condition the grape farming was done, when the grapes were uh, were taken out for the wine, what the machinery was used in the wine, what process was followed, when the bottling was done, when the sampling was done, when the bottles were shipped from the wine factory to the warehouse of the company, when company warehouse shifted that bottle to the distributors, distributor to dealers, and ultimately into the shop where somebody is going and consuming the wine. So this complete supply chain, if I can use the word, 70 odd points were taken up and all the data was fed into the system. Now, they added one more thing on the bottle, that they added a QR code. If you use the app or use the system and scan the QR code, it will tell that for this particular bottle, what are the 70 touch points and how the complete wine manufacturing process was carried out, what are the raw materials, who were the people, what were the conditions of the place, everything they will be able to read. And they could create a huge connect with their consumer of their wine, that yes, the company which is taking money, which is premium, and whatever they are saying are really being executed. And here is the proof, here is the data. And that's how the complete blockchain technology was used by the wine manufacturer. Want to ask anybody want to ask anything on this?
Yes, sir. Myself, Jayesh Prajapati. Sir, I would like to just ask a simple question. As you have said that as a end user, person will come to know that from where it has been manufactured and who all were when involved in that process and all. But ultimately, I think as a normal business, ultimately for the same thing with such additional data, if ultimately cost is going too much high, then I think in that case, it will become more, what you can say, that costlier for the end user. And ultimately, this type of approach may even constrain the business chain and all. That's what I am feeling. That's my feeling. That's what I'm just saying. Well, what is your view for that? Because what you have said is ultimately starting from...
I agree. I understood your question. All of your concern about the cost, see, when you learn the technology, throw the cost out of your mind. I would like to give the suggestion. Let me complete. Okay, so otherwise, no new technology is coming, no new technology is going to be cheaper one. The capability which it is going to offer would be manifold. And if you do not have a vision, if you do not have a use case, how to leverage those capabilities, then it would be always very costly. I would like to say here for this particular case, wine, which is a real life, you can go and find it out on internet. They added the cost of roughly $5 to $10 per bottle. Okay. Oh. Now they are selling the one bottle at $1,000. So their cost was very, very trivial per bottle. But for that, to reach to that level, you need to have that level of the scale. You need to have the value of your product that very, very high. If I say that they are, as an example, they are manufacturing 10 million bottles every year and they are spending $10, it means they are spending $100 million for blockchain technology, then everybody will feel that it is very, very costly. But cost is not to be seen in terms of the isolation. You have to see that what value you are adding, and with reference to your product, what percentage of value you are adding vis-a-vis what extra disproportionately high value you are adding, that comparison one should do actually.
Yes. Okay. Agree. Thank you, sir.
I'm mentioning some of the use cases here, that real estate, there was a blockchain utilization, voting, someone try particular year it is written in South Korea, that e-voting through the blockchain. So once I have voted, nobody can change at later date the data of my to whom I voted and whatnot. So Japan has already completed this type of the experiment in terms of the identity has become a greatest challenge in the cyber world. So how to ensure that my identity will not be stolen and somebody will not misuse it. So Swiss Federal Railway is testing some identity related solution. We are familiar with IPO, that is our initial offer of the shares. There are use cases where the complete equity was offered into the blockchain. It was the IPO was not launched into any of the national in any country's share market exchange or other thing. It was done purely on the blockchain environment. So it was a completely different use case. In case of the marine insurance, blockchain power platform was used to ensure that all the activities which are going on in the marine should have the correct identity. I would also like to use one particular word. My data is secure. It is immutable. Nobody can change. And as a result, I will always be happy because no counterfeit is the word. Counterfeit can be used. I would like to give an example that I am sending, let's say, 25 containers. And on this 25 container, I have created a blockchain related identity. So nobody can replace this 25 container during the shipment from one country to another country. So nobody can offer me something counterfeits, because person who is sent will not be able to see that what person is receiving into the other country. So that's the blockchain data is going to give me. Cryptocurrency, we are anyway well aware. Foreign exchange related transactions are being. Food safety, wine is, you can say, one example of the food safety one, but it was a different one. Here the Walmart is going to use the blockchain from the different perspective. Dairy and farmer are using this in particular because they have a perishable product. They should be able to identify that something which has already completed its life, shelf life of the product should not be in use. So this is a different dimension from the food perspective. Stock exchange is using to store their data, so no data can be manipulated. My intellectual property related rights or my digital asset related activity, I am using it. I can go on telling, there are many. My patient data, that is hospital related data, I'm storing into the blockchain. Land registry related data. So all these things are giving me a capability to stop the malfunctioning or the compromise of the data, or to create some fraud at the later date by changing the previous data. All the ultimate objective you will find at the bottom something like this only. Blockchain in combination with the IoT, agriculture is being utilizing this. Pharmacy is using this. I can tell that in the case of the pharmacy, individual tablets they are trying to connect with the IoT to a level that the patient has consumed that particular tablet or not. It's possible to track. To that level, technology is being deployed. smart home, we are so many of us are well aware that I want to have my curtains in my control with the remote control, or the my AC should be under my control, or my fridge, refrigerator, whatever devices are there should be under my control. So where I will store this data, I can store this data into the my blockchain related activity, and anything related, any crime related activity happen, I can utilize this data, and I can leverage on the blockchain technology. Automotive industry, each vehicle is getting IoT number, and in particularly vehicle, the world is moving the under UV or UMV, I can say, that is unmanned vehicle is the trend which is going on, and unmanned vehicle can be maybe a category of the IoT be accepted. All these things will have only one thing, that is data. Enormous amount of the data, because every second they are going to throw so much of volume of the data, and that data is so important, so accurate, is required, that analyzing that data, nobody should doubt, or nobody even should say that this the data has been compromised, and that's how the blockchain technology will be used. Supply chain, we have already seen some examples. See, education, I wanted to say something that we can create a blockchain, let's say from the UGC, AICT, and for every institute, I can create an identity on the blockchain, so nobody can change that identity. Every faculty member can be given an identity, so nobody, no faculty member is unknown. Student related identity can be established. Whenever result processing is done, I will publish my result into the blockchain related environment. So I don't need any transcript or other thing. Whenever I want to go to study from one country to another country, or one institute to another institute, everything is available into the public blockchain, where data is available in read-only mode. Only the institute which is publishing has only the right mode, and that is write once only, because if you write once, then you have only the read mode. I can even store my answer book, scan and store into the blockchain environment. If anybody has any doubt in terms of that, my answer books have been changed. I never had I wrote 60 pages and I am getting this many pages. All such things, or all such use cases, are very, very valid use cases into the education. Now, if you really go by cost, will become problematic. But if you really want to know that this is a genuine candidate, this is a genuine faculty, and at the abstract layer, the type of the frauds which are happening. Recently, I'm sure all of you would have come across the news that 25 fake university has been announced by the UGC. I'm saying last 1 week news. So all these things can be controlled, can be eliminated, and we can really use the technology for the much better purpose. In terms of the challenging, quantum computing has already started giving the challenges to the blockchain, because the blockchain, one of the immutability part was that I cannot go with my classic computer or with my binary computer, I cannot go back and change the data of my all the blocks by the time the new block is created. But quantum computing is so fast, and there are bridge available between the quantum computing and the my classic computer, that if somebody really deploy, if somebody can afford that cost, somebody is determined that I want to make sure that the some system collapse, then yes, blockchain immutability is at the stake conceptually. The speed is another challenge which blockchain has to resolve. Which various projects are going on. Consensus mechanism is one of the important dimension. I'm sure would go in a lot more detail. There are many consensus mechanism available. When I say consensus mechanism, let's say there are 50 active node at the moment in the world, if I want to add one more block, and consensus has to come. So there are different methods, different mechanisms through which the consensus is coming in. And there are different type of the challenges or the methodology being followed. There is something called 51% attack all these things you should try to explore and learn in this. And with this, I would like to complete this. I believe it's last 10 minutes. So if anybody wants to ask any question, please feel free to ask.
So there is one question.
Yeah.
Sir, you said that how blockchain has transformed that wine business to gain the confidence of customers, right?
Yes.
But then who will ensure the correctness of data? Say, for example, you said whenever the seeds have been picked up, it will be added to a blockchain block that these seeds are collected for this wine bottle. But then who will assure the correctness of this data that really these seeds are being picked up?
Okay, I'll ask you one simple question. Whenever result is declared by your particular college or any college, who ensures the data which is published on the net is correct?
University itself.
Anybody and everybody can doubt that data, right?
Yeah, I would like to just, sir, put my view over there.
It is the agency who will feed the data, and along with the feeding the data, see, it is not the one agency who would be doing. There are 20 agencies who would be given the access related to their data, and they will feed that data. And along with that data, they will also add the proof of that data, whatever has been fed into the system, and you will have the credibility of that data.
Yeah, if it has been in a such a channelized way, then it's fine really, sir. So there is no doubt about that.
Sorry, your voice is not clear. I'm not able to listen.
Yeah, if it is a channelized way by which you have already said, for that the person or the some authorized channels are there, then definitely there will be no matter of doubt on all such things and all. So in that sense, sir, yes, we are agree with you.
No, even if you go by, I don't know whether all of any one of you are aware with the contract farming or not, all these things are happening today also, that there are large companies like, let's say, Balaji Wafers or the Pepsi Oseor are offering you the let's say the wafers as an simple example. So they do the contract farming of the potato, and each and every stage, even without using the blockchain, they are doing or they are ensuring that each and every step is done and followed as per the standard process and the contract which has been done between the two parties or the multiple parties actually.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, next question, please.
Sir, one more last thing, just I would like to ask, like normally in the corporate world or in the business world, Asia or the India is to be considered as the largest market, and ultimately by the overall discussion, just I have concluded one thing: if the things which comes through this blockchain process and all the things, ultimately to the end customer, no? Increase the overall cost and all that thing. So once again, I'm saying that particularly for Asian market point of
view. Your voice is very noisy. I'm not able to listen actually. I don't know. A lot of background noise is coming in.
Okay. I'm just trying to type something.
Not able to listen anything.
Okay, sir. I will just try to mail later on.
No, you can put it in the chat box and in the chat window, and I'll be able to read.
Yes. Okay, sir. Okay, I will do that thing.
Sir, one question is there.
Yeah.
What is Ethereum coded in?
See, that I think tomorrow, 21st is full day for the Ethereum, and let Amit Johri explain everything on the Ethereum. It would be too much to explain in such short period of next 3 to 5 minutes.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir. And sir, one more question.
Yeah.
You said that blockchain technology is costly compared to the current solutions available. So how, if we want to apply that to a government sector, say for a voting system, can you please share one of the use case in detail, the little bit detail, where blockchain is used for voting or some other thing?
I'll quickly ask you one simple question. Would you like to buy, let's say very simple thing, a card from some nookad place, or you would like to buy a masti dahi from Amul at 30% premium price?
Amul dahi.
Okay, so you are looking something beyond money, right?
Yes. Okay.
So when say that voting is to be done at the country level, or let's say even state level, or whatever may be the level, credibility of the system is more important rather than the cost. And and if I can say that, okay, whatever election, whosoever has vote to whomsoever has been registered properly, and there is no malfunctioning. So there are a lot of, see, there were, when there were manual system, I don't know whether you have seen the videos and TV news and other thing, the booth capturing used to happen. And people used to even put the whole ballot boxes on fire and other thing. All such scenarios were there. From there, the system improved, very costly one. We came to a level that we have a current voting system, which is a technology driven. There people started challenging that I am giving the vote, but technology is really giving the internally counting vote to the same person, or it is giving the vote to the some other person. So how you are going to solve this problem? So there has to be a mechanism through which whosoever is voter there should have a confidence. You have to create a confidence in the voter that if you are giving a vote to ABC candidate, then the counter of the ABC candidate has been added, right? So now one more thing has come, that whatever vote you are giving, there is a slip which is getting printed and it is being written. So in the future, if let's say the whatever numbers have been given by the system, if somebody challenged, then the whatever printout has been taken out at the same time, they can be cross-checked and the numbers can be tallied. So this is a manual system. Now I am saying that instead of this, I am adding a blockchain whereby the data will go into the system. Every voter has their own unique voting, the election commission's ID. So I can put my election commission ID into the blockchain, and I can see that my voting has been to the same candidate or not. So this would be a great plus, great confidence into the each and every citizen of the country that whatever vote they are doing is absolutely as per their choice only. There is no malfunction, there is no fraud. One more thing, people will not require to go to their own place to the voting booth. They can use any of the system. They can apply their identity, their digital identity, their public key, private key, digital signature identity, and they can give the vote. So currently, India is losing millions of man days in terms of the voting system. All those laws will go. So you have to see the system in, so you have to see the application in totality. And cost of the technology should not be seen in isolation, but what benefit ultimately you are going to derive, and what type of the cost saving that you are doing in into the complete environment, complete ecosystem, that will put you the right metrics, and you will be able to judge the use of the technology correctly.
Sir, that would be a great thing if we can achieve this in India.
It is all in your hand. As a youth, you have a doubt, then I have a problem. You say that yes, we, the next generation of the India, will achieve it. That's what I want to really listen.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Okay.
Sir, am I audible?
Yeah,
yes, you are good. Audible. Please go ahead.
Sir, no, I'm done. If anybody has any question, then feel free to ask, or you may proceed for the next session.
Sir, there is one question.
Yeah.
Please hold on. Yes, go ahead.
Sir, you said no, some exchange rates we are imposing to the transactions. So who is going to get this, if we are paying some exchange rate for that transaction, and who is going to get that money?
See, all payment is to be made by the user only, and the person who has installed the crypto ATM or crypto exchange, who have done a lot of investment in that, obviously they will get it. See, currently when you are doing any share transaction, who gets the brokerage?
Okay.
Service provider.
Same. So both are like NSE will also get some share, or the BSE, wherever it is, whosoever is your broker, they all will get money from that particular, otherwise how they will exist? And they are doing this for the business. So how they will do the profit?
Okay.
Yes. I agree.
So there is one more question from participant.
Yeah.
Is it the distributed ledger technology is part of blockchain, or is it something different? Can you please elaborate?
It is a synonym of the blockchain.
Okay, it is the underlying technology.
Distributed ledger technology word is a synonym of the blockchain. Blockchain word came by its typical nature that one block, second block, third block, it is getting added and a complete chain is getting formed. And that's what is the blockchain. Earlier, block and chain were two different words. But now both have been combined and one has become, both put together, blockchain put together has become acceptable terminology and the phrase and the word actually. The distributed ledger technology is showing, the name is showing the nature of the technology, that it is quite distributed in nature, that at one place it is not there, it has to be at 20 place, 50 place. And why the ledger? Because the transactions which are maintained into the blockchain is ultimately considered as a ledger. That if you really want to see a transaction, what all Kalpesh Parikh has done in the blockchain, then you can see the ledger of the Kalpesh Parikh, but it is all distributed as a concept in terms of the technology. So it is distributed ledger technology term.
Okay, is there any question from any other participant? Okay, so thank you so much, sir, for your valuable knowledge, and the use cases that you have shown will be very helpful in understanding the future research opportunities for us. Thank you for being with us. Thank you.
Okay, thank you everybody, and wish you best of luck for thank your you this new learning for these 5 days, and I'm sure if you will take interest, you will be able to learn a lot, and your responsibility is one more that you have to add this thing into your syllabus for the students who are enrolling from the recent year. That's what will help the technology propagating into the current generation. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.